She did indeed have fun times in her youth, but they did not last. A couple of years later, she still defends the hookup culture and encourages one-night stands, but she softens, saying, maybe we're beginning to also allow ourselves more nuanced feelings about our hookups. Like Klausner and Anderson, we can now acknowledge regret over a one-night stand without being considered or seeing ourselves as forever ruined women. Just a year later, she begins to express second thoughts about casual sex, stating that most people find friends with benefits relationships to be overwhelmingly negative. At some point, she realized that, despite her insistence otherwise, she actually wanted those sorts of intimacies, not with an actual commitment. Her descent into absolute sluttery isn't quite done yet, though. 2 years later, in 2012, she sees her favorite male porn star in a bar and decides she has to fuck him. So she does. The sex is the narcissistic, hollow, real sex one would expect from such an encounter. It's exactly what I had breathlessly watched him do many times before, but this time it seemed mechanical and theatrical. Instead of being entertained, I was doing the entertaining, and I suspect he was too, but for women. But for whom exactly? We were the only audience. Despite the emptiness of it, she felt a sense of accomplishment over my conquest. Yet a little while later, she begins to question herself and began to feel shameful. What kind of man would want to be with a woman who slept with a male porn star? But don't worry, her hollow, meaningless sex had meaning. It made her a better person. She now has a whole new appreciation for the difference between fantasy and reality. And how much sexier the latter can be when you aren't striving for pornographic perfection. By pure coincidence, not too long thereafter, I got into a relationship with just such a guy. This had absolutely nothing with the profound sadness and hollowness she felt from her conquest. At this point, she's careening towards the wall, face first. The combination of aging and her empty experience with the porn star sent her into a frenzy of self-introspection. She realized she spent her 20s having lots of good sex, but faked her way through nearly every climax. She now climaxes reliably, sometimes even effortlessly, with Steve, which seemed nothing short of a miracle. She finds out she likes having relationships, and ones which grow out of hookups. Realizing that she likes relationships, she then does exactly what every modern woman does when faced with age and emptiness, starts demanding real courtship. Just half a year after she shags a man porn star on the first night and writes about her awesome relationship with Steve, she finds a new bold, but this one is different. This beta boy doesn't start with hookups like Steve, though he brings her aging self flowers. She is shocked to find that traditional courtship is pretty great, yay for her. But unlike the porn star or Steve, beta boy does not get sex that same night. Nope. Beta boy is special, and there's a specialness in waiting until you're comfortable enough with someone to get naked together while totally sober. Beta boy has to work for what she gave the rest of the world so freely. He had to go on 5 dates, pay for big meals, pick her up in a cab, etc.